I met my girlfriend at Cheltenham Spa. We were getting on a train heading north. I said, I got something special, but you'll have to wait until we get on board. Well, the train was rather crowded, but the quiet coach seemed cozy, and everything seemed oh so rosy. But I was getting twitchy and my fingers were getting itchy and my temperature started to soar. She said, okay, what's cooking? I could see the way you're looking. I couldn't help myself and I whipped it out and I said, hey honey, it's my new phone. Check it out, it's my new phone. Well, the sharpie take a breath should have made me circumspect as people shied away and rolled their eyes. But I was on a roll, and as I dug myself a hole, I thought that my street cred was on the rise. I've got apps on my apps, I've got YouTube, I got maps, know what the weather's like in Lima and where the grass is greener. I let my sat nav run to destination fun, avoiding all the lows and find the highs. Well, I can surf the net, make a bet or call a vet, test drive virtual cars or navigate the stars with my new phone. With my new phone. The limitless downloads of ringtones took its toll as gleefully I played back each one I found. Farting rhinos, drum and bass, sing something simple, amazing grace, belching winos, Shostakovich, howling hounds. But the guard had had enough of all this techno guff. There was only one solution to all this noise pollution, so they kicked us off at Belper, where the train don't even stop. There's no signal and my phone made not a sound. Someday there'll be an app that will live my life for me, and I'll be an ectoplasmic anomaly inside my phone. Bring it on, inside my phone. It's not for you, honey, inside my phone. Inside my phone.